Hey, I'm Dane Cook, and this is the worst I've ever bombed. The year was 1993. I was in a comedy group. People called us a troupe. Nobody wants to be called a troupe. We're in a comedy group. And we had the opportunity, we did sketch and improv. We had the opportunity to do a show at Boston Garden, which is about, you know, at that time, I think that version of the Garden was about 18,000 people. And they did a big thing called the Rock of Boston, which is all these bands would come together. And on this particular year, it was going to be Phish and Spin Doctors. So they asked our group, since we were so big in and around Boston for a few years, to be a part of it. So we get there and we're psyched. We're playing the Boston Garden. We've gone from playing, like, you know, college stuff and a few hundred people maybe to this gig. And we really believed in our youth that we would blow the roof off the joint. Little did we know that they had a set to go on later in the night. We thought we'd open up the show, like, where there were still people kind of coming in and out or whatever. So we said, how late are we going into the show? They said, we're gonna put you on after the Spin Doctors and before the headliners, Phish. And we knew that that might not be a great spot, but we were still so naive and young that we were like, but we're still gonna kill it. We get called out on stage and the crowd actually, like, applauds and people are excited. But I think they thought we were an a cappella group because they really got really quiet and listened. For about 20 seconds, we felt like we had the room completely on our side. And then almost instantly, everybody in the place starts looking back and forth at each other. We could see it happening. We could see people, like, going like this. You never want to see the lean and then the tilt, because that's like, hey, do you know what? And then a swear is probably happening when it goes low. Hey, do you know what's going on here? And as if they had rehearsed it, this crowd of people, about 15,000 people threw their shoes at us. Like, so many pairs of shoes and a lot of sandals, because it was Phish, came out of the dark and was, I mean, I'm talking about everywhere. Like it had rained, like it was something biblical with shoes. So we're standing there and we're completely freaked out. And one of the guys in the group grabbed the microphone and he kind of did this, like, impassioned speech of why they should stop doing that and listen to us. And I remember being behind him. His name's Bobby, Robert Kelly, funny comedian, good buddy of mine. I go, Robert, we gotta go. Dude, let's just go, let's just get out of here. And he was like, no, we came here to put on a show for you people. And then the second wave was lighters. Thousands of lighters started coming through the dark. And I describe it like being on stage, it was like the opening of Saving Private Ryan. You could hear them whizzing by your head. They were bouncing all over the place. You were nailing us. I remember I got hit in the neck, huge welt immediately. We came off stage. I remember I went right home. I'd never bombed before like this. I'd had, like, you know, what a mediocre sets as a comedian, but I'd never been sick to my stomach. And I went under the sheet and I stayed there for probably an entire day and a half. And I just never wanted to show my face again. But if anything, I was like, someday I hope I will return to the Boston Garden and maybe I'll have a better second go. Worst bomb ever.